This is the season of restoration. God is a restorer. He wants to give back what the enemy has stolen from his people and his children. You know, in Isaiah 58, this is a foundational chapter that the Lord gave my husband and I over 25 years ago. And he said, this is your ministry. This is what I'm giving you to do, the work that you have to do. And in verse 12 of Isaiah 58, and they shall be of thee shall build the old waste places, or the ruined places. And thou shalt raise up the foundations of many generations. You know, we are foundational ministers. We are builders. And we want to build up the body of Christ. And that is our goal, our objective, our purpose, our destiny. And it says, and thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of paths to dwell in. You know, and that this is the time that the Lord wants to restore back to his people. And so as you listen to this message today, I want you to receive restoration from the Lord. You know, he says to cry out, restore, restore, restore. Let the prophetic voice cry out in the earth today, restore, restore, restore. You know, my name is Sherry White, and I'm coming to you from Fountain of Life Ministries International. But you know, the important thing about this message is that we hear from the Spirit of the Lord. You know, there are some of you that the enemy has come in and has taken from you. And there's been some thievery going on in the body of Christ. And in the book of Genesis, chapter 42, verse 25. Now, Joseph in the Old Testament is a type or shadow of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord, our Redeemer, our Deliverer. And in chapter 42 of Genesis, Joseph's brothers came to him, and they were in famine. The land was in famine. It was barren. And they needed food. They needed grain. And Joseph, being a type of Jesus Christ, he says in verse 25, then Joseph commanded. That word just jumped off the page at me. Joseph commanded that their sacks, his brother's sacks, be filled with corn, and to restore every man's money into his sack, and to give them provision for their way, and thus he did unto them. You know, and this is the same thing that Jesus Christ did for us. He died on the cross for us, but he rose again. He rose again to carry out or execute his will. And his will is that we prosper and be in health even as our soul prospers. And in this verse right here, Joseph said, you know, he's commanded. And I believe that the Lord right now has commanded restoration to come to you and to your family members. I believe that pastors are being restored to their passion and their vision. I believe that individuals that have had difficulty, and this says that he's going to restore every man's money, every person's money that has been stolen by the enemy, by trickery and manipulation and witchcraft, all those things that the curses that have fallen upon the people of God. You know, it says in Galatians chapter 3 that Jesus Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law. And right here in this very verse, I see so much that Joseph did for his brothers and Jesus is doing for his brothers and sisters right now, that he is restoring back those things that the enemy has stolen. You know, there's some of you that you have been through many doctors and you have There have been times when you thought that you were going to die. And even the doctors have given you a bad report that you were going to die. Well, in the book of Ruth, I'm turning there right now. If you have your Bibles, just turn with me. In the book of Ruth, it says that he is the restorer of life. In Ruth chapter 4, verse 15, let's read together here. And he shall be unto thee. Well, let's go back up to verse 13. So Boaz, which is also a type of Jesus Christ, took Ruth, which is a type of the body of Christ, the bride of Christ, and she was his wife. And then he went into her, and the Lord gave her conception, and she bare a son. And the women said unto Naomi, blessed be the Lord, which hath not left thee this day without a kinsman, that his name may be famous in Israel. And he shall be unto thee a restorer of thy life, and a nurturer of thy old age. For thy daughter-in-law, which loveth thee, which is better to thee than seven sons, has borne him. You know, and I look at this and I see that God is concerned about his children, and that the bride of Christ is, all things are being restored back to the body of Christ. Even the finances are coming back into the body, you know, the body of Christ, and to those that are in spiritual authority, those funds are flowing. But here he is a restorer of life. You know, it says that the thief cometh, in John 10:10, the thief cometh to steal, kill, and destroy, but Jesus has come to give you life, and to give you life more abundantly. And I believe that there are people in the body of Christ who have not, they're not living that abundant life. There's lack, there's struggles, there's worries and doubt and unbelief. And the Lord wants all of that to be gone. He wants to be your restorer today. Ooh, can you say amen? Now, in 1 Kings, there is a hand that is restored in 1 Kings chapter 13, verse 6. You know, there's much to be said for the hand ministry. And, you know, in Ephesians chapter 4, it says, and God gave some apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. You know, this is the hand ministry. And it's being restored back to the body of Christ. You know, I believe that we're going to see some changes in the structure of the church. And that God is restoring the hand ministry back to his people. In 13:6 of 1 Kings, it says, and the king answered and said unto the man of God, entreat now the face of the Lord your God, and pray for me that my hand may be restored to me again. And the man of God sought the Lord, and the king's hand was restored again to him, and it became as it was before. You know, in the book of Acts, there were miracles, there were signs, there were wonders, there were ministers going out, and great revival was breaking out in the land. And I believe that's what's going to be restored back to the body of Christ. And that's not just a fall revival or a spring revival. I believe it's going to be a revival of the passion and the vision that God has given to his people. You know, and right now I just speak restoration to some of you that have lost that passion. You've lost that excitement about the work of the Lord, and you get up every morning and you say, oh, you know, I've got to do this, I've got to do that, and there's no passion there. There's no enjoyment there. And God says he has given us all things to enjoy. So right now I speak prophetically over you that your passion will rise up again, that your vision, that a freshness will come concerning your vision and your destiny and your purpose, and that you will move and you will begin to move with the Holy Spirit. You know, in Matthew, in the New Testament, in chapter 12, verse 13, Jesus was ministering in a synagogue, and there was a man there. I mean, Matthew 12, 13. There was a man there that had a withered hand. His hand was not able to grab hold of the things of God. That hand, representing the ministries that God has given to mature the saints for the work of the ministry, for the building up or the edification of the body of Christ. I'm still in the book, Ephesians chapter 4. But in Matthew 12, 13, it says, "Then said he to the man." Now Jesus is here and he's ministering, and he says, "Stretch forth your hand." And he stretched it forth, and it was restored whole like the other. You know, and I believe that that's what's going on right now, and we are in that season of restoration. And if there's anything in your life that you need restored, you know, it also says King David knew about restoration. In Psalms 23:3, he says, "You restore my soul." My soul, you know, we're made up of a spirit, soul, and a body. And our soul is our will, our emotions, our feelings. And those things are being restored back to wholeness. W-H-O-L-E-N-E-S-S. Wholeness. God wants us whole. He doesn't want us lacking in any area of our life. And in King David knew about restoration. And he said, "Oh, restore my soul, O Lord." And then in Psalms 51, verse 12, some of you out there have lost your joy of your salvation. That when you were first born again, when you were first accepted the Lord as your Lord and Savior, you were so excited and you wanted everybody to know. You know, you got on that telephone or any place you went, you wanted to tell people about Jesus and what he had done for you. You know, and David, King David said, "Restore that joy of my salvation." And I speak that over you right now, that God will restore your joy of your salvation, of when you were first accepted the Lord and you were so excited about telling others about who he was and what he has done for you. You know, Jesus is great. God is great and greatly to be praised. You know, in Proverbs 6:31, I said the thief has stolen from some of us, and now it's time for him to give back to us sevenfold. It says in Proverbs 6:31, if the thief be caught, he must restore back sevenfold what he has stolen from you. Some of you, he has stolen your marriage. Some of you, he has stolen family members. Some of you, he has stolen your health. You know, and in Jeremiah 30:17, he says he restores our health to us. You know, I'm believing him for that. I'm believing for wholeness, and you know, in my whole spirit, my whole body, my soul, my mind. And some of you, your mind has been confused. I see confusion in the spiritual realm. I see confusion, and the Lord is bringing clarity to you. He's bringing wisdom. You know, Jesus Christ has been made into us wisdom, righteousness, sanctification, and redemption. You know, that's in 1 Corinthians. And it says that he is restoring all of that back to us, that we will make wise decisions, that we have a sound mind. You know, in 1 Timothy, it says that we do not have a spirit of fear, but we have a spirit of power, love, power, and a sound mind. That's who we are. That's who you are. And we cry out, restore, restore, restore. You know, in Joel chapter 2, verse 25, it says that whatever has eaten up our finances, whatever has eaten up our health, whatever has eaten up our relationships, that the canker worm and the locust and the palmer worm, that God is restoring back to us those things that those worms, those parasites have come and eaten away. I truly believe this, and I am believing this for my family, and I am believing this for myself, and I am praying that you will receive your restoration today. You know, we can help restore others. In Galatians chapter 6, verse 1, it says, those that are spiritual restore one another. You know, we can do that. If we see someone that has fallen off and gone to the left or gone to the right or followed something that they shouldn't have followed, gotten into a mess that they shouldn't have gotten into, we can restore that person by the love of God and the mercy of God and the compassion of God, and with the spirit of restoration in our innermost being coming out of our mouth, we can restore that individual back into the fellowship of the Lord. You know, and that's the bottom line about restoration, is coming back into fellowship with our Father and with Jesus Christ the Son and with the Holy Spirit. That is the bottom line of this season of restoration. I am excited about being restored, that people being restored back into fellowship with the Father. And I want to pray for you right now. Those of you that have had sickness in your body, and you've accepted that sickness and that spirit of infirmity, I tell it to go in the name of Jesus. Arthritis, I tell you to go, especially rheumatoid arthritis. I tell you to go in the name of Jesus, and for your body to be restored to wholeness and to perfect health in the name of Jesus. I ask the Lord right now to restore eyesight. Those of that you've even you're even scheduled for cataract surgery, I'm asking the Lord right now to, with His laser light, you know, He is light, and with His light, that He will come in and He will restore your sight to you without having to have that surgery in the name of Jesus. Those of you that are financially strapped and struggling right now in the name of Jesus, some of you have lost your job and you've been without a job for a while, I speak jobs to be released to anyone who needs a job. Believe the Lord and He will restore a job back to you in the name of Jesus. He will restore those finances to you in Jesus' name. I thank you for viewing today. Receive God's restoration. God bless you.